What are the differences between spinal cord and brain? Spinal cord is generally passing the information, yes? So information generally is created in the brain. Decision, maybe let's get it more precise. Decisions are mainly made in the brain and are mainly passed by the spinal cord. Of course, some simplification. But information needs to get from the brain, yes, out, and to the brain in. In order to get this information, it needs to be relayed. Yes, like for example, if you have a computer with internet, you need to have this internet relayed somehow. Yes, and in order to be able to search anything, you need to have a connection to the internet to get some information out and some information in. With the brain is the same. So brain is mainly a decision-making center. The spinal cord is mainly the relaying center. So it coordinates the inputs from the most of the body. Yes, below the neck. but as I told you before, this is some simplification, some good thing, some good picture to keep in mind. However, as always in medicine, there are some small letters attached. So, for example, in the spinal cord, there are some reflexes that are living only in the spinal cord and that would not reach the brain. Yes, these are some primitive reflexes. Like, for example, stretch reflex. Yes, so for example, when a doctor would use a hammer to put this hammer on your knee, you would kick. Yes, this is connected with the stretch reflex, and this stretch reflex would get from the muscle to the spinal cord and from the spinal cord back to the muscle without using the brain. Yes, so decision. Extremely simple decision was made already in the spinal cord. So both brain and spinal cord are the central nervous system. They are able to make some decisions. However, these kinds of decisions are completely different. In the brain, we have some advanced decisions that when we think in the brain, yes? In case of the spinal cord, these are only some primitive reflexes. Yes. Also, there is some anatomic change. Also, you know that there is a gray matter and white matter. Yes. Gray matter is mainly for this decision making, for analysis of informations, and to passing the information. We have a white matter. So, gray matter analyzing the information, white matter passing the information. In case of the brain, we have gray matter around, white matter inside. In case of the spinal cord, we have a gray matter, white matter around, gray matter inside. You can think about this that the outer side is more important, yes, because spinal cord is mainly relaying the information, so it has the white matter around. Brain has a gray matter around because it's mainly is transforming and analyzing the information. Okay, thank you very much.